Good morning, Magic! I'm Gavin Verhey from Wizards of the Coast, and returning in Zendikar Rising is the kicker mechanic. This fan-favorite mechanic has been around Magic for a while, and is coming back to Zendikar for the second time. But what's its history? How did it get here? And why do I kind of hate it so much? Let's dig in. Alright, so picture this. It's the year 2000, Magic has been around for just 7 years at this point, and the set Invasion comes out in fall. It's Magic's first ever multicolor block, it has a lot of cool stuff going on, and it's got this new mechanic, Kicker. Now, Kicker is a pretty straightforward mechanic. You pay the extra cost when you play the card, you get an extra bonus out of the card. It's just that simple. But it always makes the most sense when it's doing something else in the set, when it ties into the theme somehow. And Invasion was a multicolored set. So while there were plenty of colorless Kicker costs running around, some of the most memorable ones were the ones that had a different color than the card's primary mana cost. For example, with the card Probe, which is just a ridiculous common by the way, I mean check this one out, you could cast it for blue mana for its main effect, but if you had black, you could kick it up a notch and do something a little bit extra. Or in this case, a lot of it extra. And Kicker definitely evolved to be even more this way as the block went on. In Planeshift we had the Battle Mages, and in Apocalypse we had the Volvers. Now by the end of it, some of them were a little extreme. For example, Desolation Angel, which is a 5-4 flyer that destroys all of your own lands, or when you kick it, destroys everyone's lands. Yeah, I think I'm not gonna cast this one unkicked very often. Also, while we're talking about old Invasion block kicker cards, quick throwback to Phyrexian Scuta. Can you believe this was the card people were most excited about from Planeshift? Wild. So after Invasion block, the mechanic went away. It came back for a brief stint in Time Spiral block, because what mechanic didn't have a brief stint in Time Spiral block? But it returned in earnest 9 years later in the original Zendikar. And this time, it was up to something a little bit different. Zendikar was a set all about lands, and so as a result, you'd end up with tons of lands in play. And what better to do with all that mana than to cast a kicker card? And in this set in particular, there were a bunch of really expensive kicker costs that you could do in the really late game if you had the mana lying around. Now, Worldwake evolved kicker in two ways. The first way is multi-kicker, which let you kick your spells multiple times. Good name for the mechanic, I guess. Now, the second one is probably a lot less known. That's a card that rewards you for kicking your spells in Rumbling Aftershocks. Now, it's a very forgettable card, it's not very strong, but it paves the way for something important, which we'll get to in a second. Alright, so let's flash forward past some ancillary sets and get to Dominaria. We're returning to the plane for the first time in 11 years, and we want a mechanic that is reminiscent of the world. Well, Kicker comes right to mind because of Invasion Block. That was a place where a lot of players started playing Magic, and so hey, makes a lot of sense to return to a fan favorite mechanic. Now, Kicker always plays well, and Dominaria was no exception, but we did do something a little bit different here. Remember Rumbling Aftershocks? Well, in Dominaria, that card paved the way for some cards that cared about Kicker, and there's a red-green strategy built around kicking up your spells. Flash forward past a few ancillary sets, and we're here, Zendikar Rising. And just like the original Zendikar, it's all about kicking up your spells with the extra mana you have lying around. But since the original Zendikar happened, we've picked up a few tricks. For example, there are cards here in Zendikar Rising that reward you for kicking up your spells. Thanks, Dominaria. Okay, so that's the history of Kicker, and it sounds pretty great, right? I mean, players love it, it generally makes sets better, it's really smooth. What's not to love? Well, now I'm going to tell you the reason why I kind of hate Kicker. As a Magic designer, Kicker is just too broad. I mean, you pay some mana and you get an extra effect. That's like a ton of Magic mechanics. Let's go through a few. Entwine? Just Kicker. Exploit? Just Kicker. Buyback? Just Kicker before Kicker even existed. Replicate? That's just multi-kicker. Just Kicker, just Kicker, just Kicker, just Kicker, just Kicker, kinda sorta Kicker, still Kicker, like a Kicker style kind of thing. Kicker, but for an entirely different reason. Not Kicker, but like you can kind of see it as Kicker, right? Kicker again. So as a result, we try and be pretty judicious with Kicker. Does this set actually need Kicker, or would a different new mechanic do just the same job that we're looking for? And in fact, in Zendikar Rising, we did try a new mechanic. The mechanic was called Titan. So what did Titan do? Well, it sort of represented the lingering Eldrazi influence on Zendikar. It would be on a card, let's say Field Research as an example, but instead of Kicker, it would have a Titan cost. Now, Titan costs were all colorless, so any color could play them. And then when you cast it, you get a bonus upgraded effect for doing so. So for example, you can play Field Research in your blue deck as a 3-mana draw 2, or for 7-mana, any color could play it as, say, a draw 3. The Zendikar Rising team tried out Titan for a while, but eventually they decided that good old-fashioned Kicker was just the way to go. And you know what? I think they're right. To me, this is a classic example of how something can irk a game designer, and it doesn't matter, because it's good for the players. Yeah, it is a less clean superset of other mechanics, but that doesn't mean it's not fun to play and people don't love it. So am I glad we used it in Zendikar Rising? Absolutely. So when will we see Kicker again in a main set? Well, the simple answer is when there's a good reason for the main set to use it. What do you think about Kicker? Which set do you think it was used the best in? And would you have preferred Titan in Zendikar Rising or the Kicker that we got? Let me know in the comments below. I'll talk with you again on Friday, and in the meantime, may you have fun kicking up all your spells. You got this. Many years ago, a small group of players started playing a multiplayer variant of Magic using the Elder Dragons from Legends, and this format evolved into what we know as Commander today. Commander is a format which came up through the community, and so we wanted to keep it with the community. And so it is our only major format which is not mostly managed by people here at Wizards of the Coast. It's managed by the Commander Rules Committee.